Let's come to the next topic, factors affecting the resistance of a conductor. You already know that what is resistance? Resistance is the opposition offered by the conductor to the flow of current. The resistance is, what is resistance? Resistance is equal to the V upon I. What is V? V is the potential difference and I is the current that we have obtained from the Ohm's law. Now we will see that what are the factors that affect the resistance of a conductor. In the Ohm's law, what we have studied that the V is, or the potential difference, is directly proportional to the current only when the physical conditions of the conductor remain unchanged. That is the temperature, the length, area of cross section, or the diameter of the conducting wire or the conductor must remain constant throughout the experiment. Otherwise, the Ohm's law will not be obeyed. That is, the resistance of the conductor is affected by the three factors. First is the length of the conductor, second, area of cross section of the conductor, and the third one is the temperature of the conductor. Then we will see in detail. First, the length of the conductor, that is L. R is directly proportional to L. That means the resistance of the conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. That means that the length, if the length increases, the resistance of the conductor also increases. Suppose you are given two wires of same area of cross section but of the different lengths. Here is the wire 1 and this is the wire 2. The first wire is length is L1 and the second wire length is L2. And from the figure you can easily understand that L1 is greater than L2. That means according to this, resistance is directly proportional to length. That means the resistance of the first wire, that is the longer wire, will be greater than the second wire whose length is shorter. Second factor. The second factor is area of cross section. What is area of cross section? Suppose this is a wire. This is the circular cross section. That is called the cross sectional area. Or we can say that the diameter of the wire. R is inversely proportional to the area of cross section. That means as the diameter or the thickness of the wire increases, the resistance will decrease. That is, if you are given two wires of the same length but of the different cross-sectional area, that is, one is thicker and other is thinner. Both are having the same length, but here the first wire has the thickness greater than the second wire. If the thickness or the area of cross-section of the first wire is A1 and second wire is A2, and A1 is greater than A2, then according to this statement, R is inversely proportional to area of cross section. What we conclude, that the resistance of the first wire will be less than the resistance of the second wire. That is, R1 is less than R2. From this, what we have concluded, that the thicker wire has the lesser resistance than the thinner wire. Third one is the temperature of the conductor, and resistance is directly proportional to the temperature of the wire. That means if the temperature of the wire increases, its resistance increases. Now the question is, why does the resistance of the conductor increases with the increase in the temperature? We know that the resistance of a conductor is due to the collisions among the electrons and with the walls of the wire, and also with the walls of the atoms and the ions. Therefore, as with the temperature is increasing, the number of the collisions between the electrons and the other electrons, and for the electrons and the atoms and ions also increases. As the number of the collisions increases, there will be obstruction in the flow of the electrons. That means the resistance will increase. Therefore, resistance is directly proportional to the temperature. Thus, from the three factors, what we conclude, that the resistance is directly proportional to the length, inversely proportional to area of cross section. On combining the two factors, we can write R is directly proportional to L upon A. R is directly proportional to L upon A. If we remove the proportionality sign here, what we put here? R is equal to rho L by A. Here the symbol is rho. R-H-O. It is pronounced as rho. What is rho? Rho is the proportionality constant. It is known as the resistivity of the conductor. Resistivity of the conductor. Also, it is known as the specific resistance of the conductor.